Sport dominated by giants, Kevin finds success through technique perfected by hours of repetition.
Good. Doc, that time you hit here. Try to get your foot up to here. If you get your foot up to here, you're going to get another 2 feet on the throw.
Kevin's father, Dominic, earns a modest living operating his local bar, Diorgio's. He was a fine athlete in his youth, and his ability on the football field earned him acceptance into Columbia University. And when his son showed interest in sports at an early age, Dominic was there to guide him.
He taught me everything I know. He's always around when I need a question to ask him. He threw it too, so he knows a little bit about it, and he reads up on books and videos and everything like that. So he's really good.
And he first wrestled for his first semester of his freshman year. And then he wasn't too thrilled with the wrestling, so I remembered I was in track and field when I was younger. And I started looking in the newspapers at the distances these kids were throwing the shot put now. Some of them 47, 48 feet were winning the county championship. I used to throw 57, I wasn't even the county champ in my day. So I said, hey, Kevin, look at these distances. Going into track and field, I guarantee you that you'll at least be a county champ. You know, and then it just kept going from there. It kept getting better and better.
Dominic has developed an unusual training regime for Kevin. Rather than emphasizing arm strength, they work to develop his hulking legs, the source of a shot putter's power. In addition to traditional methods, they employ a series of outdoor exercises you won't find in any textbooks.
It's a sort of like the world's strongest man competitions when they lift the cars and everything like that. It really gets your whole body really strong.
His talent has become so prodigious that he's outgrown his high school competition. At last year's state championships, organizers were not prepared for just how far he can throw.
This was probably, I bet you, the most interesting shot put in the history of New Jersey.
The barricade. It's a wooden railroad tie, I think they call it. It's about at 68 feet. And the kids normally hit around 60 feet for the past couple years. And I hit the barricade, and it was a big controversy, and they'd take it out of the ground and everything.
I don't know why they didn't move it. You must have... For some reason or other, they left it there, maybe hoping that he wasn't going to hit 68 or something. But he goes out there, and in a couple of practice throws, he hits the fence.
It's a big controversy, and they take it out of the ground and everything.
He hit the top of the railroad tie, but they measured it where it would have hit had the railroad tie not been there. So maybe they gave him an extra 3-4 inches on the throw.
Some doubted the validity of Kevin's new record, but a week later, he set the state record again and erased all doubts.
People were talking and everything, so next week it came out to prove that I could really throw that far, and I did. People just gathered out of the stand, everybody came around, everybody was watching me. It's pretty exciting.
Kevin's record-breaking high school career is nearing an end, and he soon will face a new level of competition. But he stands on a strong foundation with the support of his community and family. Everyone has a role, even younger brother Steven.
Sacrifice a lot of things, the parties and everything, the fun. But it's fun winning national titles and getting on TV like this. I just be right out of college from in 2004, and if I make that Olympics, I'll be real happy.
Well, you heard Kevin liken his training to a world's strongest man competition, and for pretty good reason. When Kevin's practice field is overcrowded, the ever-resourceful Dominic employs an alternate workout. Check this out. Kevin stands behind the family car and actually pushes. And just for added resistance, we hear that Dad occasionally puts his foot on the brake. He never lets up, does he? We'll be right back.
I'll be back.